Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you how to become a work from home freelancer. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you about how to buy on Fiverr. Now this tutorial will also help you if you want to become a seller on Fiverr, because you will get an idea of what to expect when someone purchases something from you and how exactly the process works. So the first thing you need to do is sign up to Fiverr if you haven't already. And if you click on my referral link in the description below, you can sign up and get 10% off of your first order. I already have an account, so I'll click sign in. So there are all sorts of different gigs that you can order on Fiverr. Now that my YouTube channel has become much larger, I have found it easier to hire out some of my thumbnails to sellers on Fiverr. So you can browse all the different categories. We've got graphics and design, tons of different categories, digital marketing, writing and translation, video and animation, music and audio, programming and tech, business, lifestyle, and trending. So for example, let's say I want to order a YouTube thumbnail. I'll type in YouTube thumbnail. And what you want to do when you are searching for a seller is scroll down and try to look for their number of reviews. Now, if you go for someone who doesn't have any reviews yet, you can probably get a really good deal. If you want faster results, you can even toggle online sellers, and this will show you sellers who are connected to Fiverr right now. You can look here and see their star rating and how many reviews have been left. You can search under service options, seller details if you want to look for a top-rated seller, a new seller. You can set your budget. So let's say my maximum budget I want to spend is 20 euro. Click apply. And delivery time. Let's say you want this to be ordered quickly. Express 24 hours, for example. Apply. You can scroll down and check out all of the different services that are available for you. If you want to try out a new seller, perhaps because your budget is much lower, you can click here, new seller, apply, and this will show you all the new sellers that are online right now. So once you find a gig that you like, you can click on it and you can also see how many orders are in queue ahead of you. So let's say the person has 20 orders ahead of you. It might take them longer to finish your order. So you might want to choose someone else, especially if it's urgent. If you want to view their reviews, you can just click here on the number and this will show you all of the different reviews. You can scroll down, see a bit more information about the gig. You can see where they're from, their average response time, and you can check out their packages. So this guy, he has a basic package, which is one simple YouTube thumbnail. Then you can look at their standard package and then also premium. You can also click on the side here and toggle through the different packages. So let's say I want the standard package. I'm going to click continue. And now we have three different steps. The first step is the order details. So I'm choosing to purchase one thumbnail for 10 euro. I can also click if I want the source file. And this means that the seller will include the source file of the delivery so you can make further edits to the design. So what this means is that if the seller is creating this on Photoshop, for example, rather than just send me the JPEG or PNG image, which I could not make edits to, they will send me the Photoshop file as well. And that way I can make any other edits I want to. If you are a seller, this is good to know, because if you are creating or want to create thumbnails on YouTube, a lot of people want to have this option as well. So you should be creating your thumbnails on Photoshop to be able to offer this option. So you can see here the subtotal and then the service fee and the total and then the delivery time. So I'm going to click continue to checkout and that will get me to confirm and pay the second step. So there's different payment options. PayPal, I've already included my PayPal information. You could also choose credit and debit card and fill out your information here. I'm going to stick with my PayPal. You can see here that this guy offers unlimited revisions, so I can keep telling him to make the edits I want until I am happy with it. If you have a promo code, you can enter that here. So I'm going to go ahead, click confirm and pay. So now we're on step three, which is submit requirements. It says, thank you for your purchase. A receipt was sent to your email address. Submit requirements to start your order. The seller needs the following information to start working on your order. Do you have any idea of what you want, or should I surprise you? So I already know more or less what I want. So first I want to tell the seller what I want for my title. So I want my thumbnail to be Rev Caption Tutorial, Finished Captions Example. Then I'll tell them the font type I want, for example, and the color scheme, and add any other information that you need. Okay, so part two, you can attach images you want to include in the thumbnail. So sometimes here you might attach even an example. Let's say you're ordering a logo and you want to include an example of the type of logo you want or some colors that you like. In my case, I'm going to attach a file of an image that I want him to include in the thumbnail of myself. So just make sure to add all the information you need so that the seller can get started. And then click here, the information I provided is accurate and complete. Any changes will require the seller's approval and may be subject to additional costs. If you're not ready to fill out this information, you can just click remind me later. I have finished adding everything I want, so I'm going to click start order. Okay, so that gets me to all of my order details on the side here. Under activity, it says your order is now in the works. We notified the seller about your order. This is when you should receive your order. And here it's showing us all the information. We've got, you've placed the order, you submitted the requirements, your order started. And I can see here that the seller is online. So if you have to ask them anything else, you can put in anything else here and click send. It's like a little messaging system. So let's say you log out of Fiverr and now you need to go back in and you want to message your seller. You can just click over here on orders, and that will show you all of your different orders. These are the ones that are completed, and this one here is in progress. So I can just click on that, and then it gets me back to this original page. You can also click here on details and see exactly what you ordered. You can click on requirements and see what you sent the seller, and then delivery. And this is where we are waiting for the seller to deliver us this order so that we can review it or ask for any changes before we close off the order. So once the seller has finished your order, here under delivery, you will see that they finished my order and the time, and it will say delivery one. Usually they will send you a message and then they will attach whatever it is you purchased from them. So in my case, they have attached the thumbnail. So you can go ahead and review the file. And at the bottom, it says you received your delivery from the seller. Are you pleased with the delivery and ready to approve it? So you can either click, yes, I approve delivery, or I'm not ready yet. If you click, I'm not ready yet, it says, what revisions would you like the seller to make? So you can go ahead and tell the seller what you want them to change. Maybe you want to change the location of some of the elements or change the color scheme. And after you write out the changes you want made, you can click Send Revision Request. Now be careful with whatever gig you purchase, because some gigs only offer you one or two revisions included, or others, like this seller, offer unlimited revisions. Then the seller will work on your revisions, and when you are happy with it, you will click Yes, I approve delivery. Then it will pop up that you approve final delivery. And here you will have an opportunity to give public feedback. You can give a rating out of 5 stars for the seller and write what it was like to work with the seller as well. The seller will also provide you with feedback as a buyer. And if you are really happy with your service, you can also offer the seller a tip, which is minimum of $5. Okay, so I hope you guys like this tutorial on how to place an order on Fiverr and hire a gig from someone. If you want to sell on Fiverr, I hope that this tutorial helped you understand a little bit about the selling process as well, and what you are expected to do as a seller when someone buys an order from you from Fiverr. Make sure to like this video if it helped you out. Click on the description below to look at my other tutorials on Fiverr, and make sure to subscribe to Jennifer Marie for more tutorials on how to become a work-from-home freelancer. Thanks again, and I will see you in my next tutorial.